In 2013, a survey that was conducted by the Ministry of Water and Environment came up with a conclusion that River Rizzi's existence might become extinct if no suitable and serious interventions are put in place. The challenges facing River Rizzi are a result of continued rampant degradation of the river catchment, especially upstream, the growing settlement of people on buffer zones with continued river pollution. Some industries are discharging toxic chemicals and waste directly into the river, and this is worsened by the emerging challenge of plastic waste in urban centers, which is all over, not forgetting the threat of the water weed, which has also emerged in the recent years, covering a big section of the river, and limited funding, which restricts the capacity of the players involved in promoting sustainable land management and biodiversity conservation initiatives. This can, however, be contained by developing sustainable water resources and water use practices in the catchment to increase water availability in the river. River Rizzi is a major source of water for millions of people in over 12 districts of southwestern Uganda. Sarah Aijuka, the NEMA Southwestern Region Manager, has called for urgent intervention to save the river. The Ministry of Water and Environment, in partnership with World Wide Fund for Nature and Nile Breweries, have launched a fresh campaign aiming at restoring River Rizzi.
Because most of the wetlands have been converted and we're doing farming in the wetlands and construction in the wetlands and sand mining, you find that all this water will just run to the River Rizzi all at once, and that is what is causing flooding and that is what is causing siltation, because the swamp or the vegetation that is supposed to be sieving that water before it gets into the Rizzi has all been cut off.
The campaign kicked off with planting of over 500 trees on 2 kilometers of the targeted 13 kilometers of the stretch on the river buffer zone. The target is to plant over 13,000 trees along the river stretch that was demarcated in 2017 by the Ministry of Water and Environment.
It's been happening here. If you were to come here a few years ago, all this vegetation had been removed. And now that makes the river vulnerable, because a lot of soil erosion and siltation is happening, impacting on the quality of the water and also the quantity for the needs of the people and the livestock and the like.
And now the engagements that have been ongoing with different stakeholders and the affected communities along the stretch of within the Mbarara city and Mbarara University, we engaged them. We said we can now start the piloting of the restoration of the buffer zone. So here we shall be seeing the pilot of the restoration of the buffer zone.
Similar projects have been implemented on River Nyawo in West Nile, River Awoja in Teso, and River Mpanga in Rwenzori, as Simon Peter Weredwong, the Conservation Program Manager at World Wide Fund for Nature, explains.
In specific terms have been piloted here for that aspect of economic resilience of the community, because it grows very fast and its value chain has a lot of great potential for economic gains.
Call to everyone who is a stakeholder, whether you're an individual, whether it's your family, whether you're farming by the river, or you are the university community that has actually donated this land, we are planting these trees, that do something to ensure that you actually making sure that we are not, whatever you're doing, you're not degrading the river.
The river catchment lies in the southwestern Uganda, providing water resources for millions of people in the region. The river has a catchment with a total area of 8,210 kilometers, covering districts of Buweju, Shema, Ntungamo, Mbarara, Ruampara, Chiruhura, Isinjiro, Lyantonde, Luengo, Chotera, and Rakai. The upper central and lower reaches of the catchment are covered by wetlands, which make up about 3.5% of the total land area. Forests make up approximately 2.5% and open water 1%, the rest consisting of open vegetation, grassland, and shrubs. The wetlands in the catchment, which would be playing an important role in capturing and storing water and releasing it into the river channel, have been degraded, leaving the river vulnerable to dry up. Story compiled by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.